Is this seriously something that we're gonna have to do, Mario? Hello everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough 100 coin star time. And this one probably won't give you all that much trouble, actually, because this level has the most coins in the entire game, like of any other level. It's got a whopping 191 coins. So you're gonna find that you're gonna have many different ways to do this. Make sure that you ground pound the Mega Goombas because they give you blue coins instead of regular gold coins, and blue coins are of course worth 5, so you do not want to miss your opportunity to get 5 coins out of them. And also don't forget about the posts. The posts still do matter, so there you go. Let's see what else we can kill around this area. And is that sign up? I need to probably use the cannon to get up there. Dang it! I wanted to hit the Lakitu like I usually do. Like jumping out of the water. Oh, dang it. Well, I can kill the fly guy for now. Give me your pocket change. I will mug you for your pocket change. It is for the good of the castle. Oh yeah, if you touch those 2 coins, you get a 1-up. I totally forgot about that. Guess you weren't. Oh, dang it. Just trying to. Oh, well, that works. I was trying to hit underneath it, you know, by punching it, because that wouldn't make me fly up like that, but eh, well. Lakitu. Get. There we go. You get 5 coins, and I definitely wanted those 5 coins. So I'm gonna go around here. Oh, God. No, don't you dare. Don't you dare. Alright, fly guy. Ground pound time, yeah! Just ground pound everything you see, it controls your jump. You, get over here, come on. Stop it. I just want to squish you with a ground pound, there we go. I know you don't appreciate being squished with a ground pound, no one does, but it's for the good of the castle. Now, these might be tricky to get some ground pounds off of. Unless I get, I'll get past the wind, see if I can stop it altogether. You there. See me? You didn't. How did you not see me? Or are you not interested in me? You. Over this way. Go on. I'm making noise. Oh, there you are. I mean, there you go. Come on. That works. Well, what I was trying to do is get it to, be attracted to me so that it would decide to. Oh no, don't you dare go off the edge. So it would decide to go after me in a safe manner, and I'd be able to guarantee my blue coin out of it, but yeah, well, that works, I guess. Alright, I'm gonna cross the Windy Valley threshold and collect coins carefully. You can always scooch by those ginormous marbles just by hugging the wall. I noticed that on a couple other playthroughs I did of the game, just makes things a little easier. Oh, got it. I wonder if I should bother with Chuckya up here. Aha! Throw you towards the wall so that your coins don't go everywhere. That would be. Oh! Coin almost went in the wall! That was. That would have been awkward, because I was trying to do it the safe way, and then. Okay, 66 coins! As I said, you can do this many, many different ways, because this level has so many coins that you just gotta pick your favorite way to do it, I suppose. I'm gonna go down this way, because there's a couple more coins. More Mega Goombas to squish. No Koopa the Quick, though, unfortunately. There's 80. I wonder if I should switch over to the micro side from here, because I can start collecting a bunch of coins on this side really easily. I mean, on the micro side rather easily. Let's just see what I can collect. No, go up, Slopey. There we go. Oh, jeez. Give me coin. Boop. Nope. I want coinages. I don't like tiny platforming, though. Oh, come on. Come around. Most dangerous enemy in the game. Oh, seriously? I lost my coin because of that? And here is Mini Koopa the Quick. And yeah, you can get a blue coin out of Koopa the Quick there. It's one of the game's little Easter eggs for switching sides. Wonder if this is safe enough to go through. Boop. No, you don't. Just trying to carefully go. No, carefully go up here. I'm just gonna ignore the harder platforming sections. Just because. Go at least follow this way, please. Thank you. I know where I can get the last 5 coins, so I'm just gonna ignore the rest of it. And go up here. You see where they are. Yeah, I'm gonna actually go across that little ledge. I noticed it's actually relatively safe to go across here, providing I don't fall on the very, very, on the very last coin, so to speak. Because that could be disastrous. There we go. And there's your 100 coin star. Enjoy! Here we go! Not too shabby. And now I can exit the course and go up to the next world, which is on the final floor of the game. This game really flew by quickly. Just 14 stars left in the remaining 2 worlds, 7 per world of course, 6 stars plus the 100 coin star. Alright, this next world here, you want to enter it at certain times that the minute hand is over a number. I'll explain how it is. If the minute hand is over the 12, everything will be stopped inside the clock. If it's over 3, it'll be slow. If it's at 6, it'll be at medium speed. If it's at 9, it'll be at high. I guess I'll start with the stopped one, even though I actually prefer having it on 3. Just because I'd like to show you guys each kind of speed, so to speak. Anyway, it starts to it. Oh, I guess it wasn't directly over 12, so I guess this is the 3. My mistake. So yeah, since everything's moving, I definitely got it over the 3. Oh, poopers. Just gotta platform your way up the tick-tock clock. Yeah, we are inside in a clock indeed. Quite a unique level gimmick, I have to say. And this is called Roll Into the Cage, by the way, so you're looking for a star inside a cage, obviously. Just gotta watch when the blocks turn, and you will be fine. It's all platforming 101 and just being patient along the way, basically. I just want to double jump up there. There we go. Rotating platforms are no problem whatsoever, and here is the star we're looking for. There's another star down there, which we also need the clock to be moving for, but meh, that's the star I was looking for this time. Yay! At least I think it was. I think it was, yeah, roll into the cage. Alright. So, I'm trying to think of which star is next. I'll keep it moving at... Well, no, I'll show you what the stopped one is like, but I might actually be a little bit off again. It might be moving again. Yep, it's moving again. Dang it! My timing entering this place is terrible, clearly. But whatever, it doesn't really matter. I can do this... I can do any star... Well, except for maybe one on any speed... I'm rather comfortable with platforming in general, so that might be why I don't mind even the fastest speed. And by the way, with these things, you don't really actually have to worry about them too much, even though they spin like that. It's a thing of they look worse than they actually are, but if you time your jumps to be in the air as they're turning underneath you, you're not going to have any issues falling off of them. Anyway. Now I'm going to skip that star this time, and keep moving along this path. If you- No! Shoot! I slipped off somehow. If you don't have the clock moving, you might have issues getting up to higher spots, so you might want to actually get comfortable doing stars while the place is in motion. Unless you're really, really good at wall kicks, of which I am not. So, most of the time I would prefer if the clock is indeed in motion, just so I can guarantee myself a star along the way. Well, you know, unless I fall to my doom like I did last time, that was something that doesn't usually happen with me in this stage. Because I'm rather... Yeah. Seriously? I was going to say, I'm rather proficient at the platforming in the stage, because the everything about the stage works really well, like with the camera and stuff like that, so it's not like you're going to be falling off very easily, so to speak, if your jumps are right on, because the camera is not going to be screwing you this stage. Don't know why this stage does so well with the camera in comparison to others, but I'm not complaining. Anyway, we're back already, where I somehow managed to fall off. I have no clue how that happened. Right, just climb up and keep following this path. Just keep going around counterclockwise. Beware that. Actually, is this the right way? Yes, it is the right way. Okay. This triangle can be a little tricky to get on, but it's not that bad if you're just aiming for the center of it. And try and jump off of the edge because it's closer to the platform you're aiming for. Alright, now over here is the star that I am looking for. By the way, that blue coin switch is really important to the 100 coin star later. And safe at this corner. Can I go on top of that block safely? I can. So I'm going to do that. And I'm going to do this. How you like that? Here we go. Just like, screw the tricky platforming, just go right to the star. Alright. Next up, gotta have the clock in motion for this one, if I remember correctly, so I'm just gonna have it there. Yes, get a hand. They're hinting at the clock hands early on in the level. You'll see what I mean. You actually gotta wait for the clock hands in order to see them, but once you know they are there, you're not gonna have any issue with the star, because you just stand on the tippy top of the arrow and you'll just be riding it all the way over to the star. Go. No. Oh, gotta wait. Just wait to be safe. Don't rush things if you don't have to, basically, in this level. And there we go. Now, this platform right here, this is the one that I'm waiting for a hand. Quite literally a clock hand. It's coming. It's slow, but it's coming. You only have to worry about one, so it's not like you have to jump over the hour hands the minute hand is going across. Actually, that's more like a second hand at the pacing that it's going. And yes, it does take a little while, so have fun waiting. Nope. Alright, I'm just gonna wait on here. And how's it going? It's a nice day. I'm just gonna take a look around this stage. There's the star we're gonna be getting. It's rather nice to take a look around this place sometimes to see how things go. Don't worry, you won't fall off this thing even when you're in first person view. I should probably switch my perspective though so that I get all of you that I can as I'm approaching the star. Even that amp there isn't all that big of a deal, because it's not where this arrowhead is. Like, you know, where the pointer is, it's not even gonna affect you in the slightest. It just, you gotta be patient and wait for it to be over. I mean, wait for the... I seriously did that. And I was being patient the whole time, too. Well, another way you can do it is to jump down on it from above, where that star in the cage was. But I can't believe I did that. That's just so freaking annoying. Come on! There we go. That works just fine. I'll do one more star in this one, I suppose, and I think I need to have the clock in motion again in order to get up there. Well, unless I am a tremendously good wall kicker, of which I'm not. Yep, stomp on the thwomp. We gotta go really high this time to get the star. So we are looking for a bunch of thwomps, and they are the only thwomps in the level, actually. And one of them lets you get high enough to get up to a star, But this is going to take me a little while to climb the clock, but you probably know the route by now, based on how many times I've been through this already in this part alone. But as for the sake of organization of the stars in the menu, I of course have to show you the pathway for each one, so follow me. Like I said, none of the jumps in this are particularly tricky, even when the clock is in motion. In fact, the clock in motion probably makes things easier in some cases, harder in some others, but it's not that big of a deal, because I think the wall kicks are much, much more difficult to get past when you have to use them instead of moving platforms. Like over here is where... Like over here is where the first wall kick issue would come into play, like, because this platform would be too high for you to just jump up normally, and then you'd have to wall kick on top of that triangle, and that's not something you really want to mess with. Where do I want to go from here, though? I guess on this triangle. Okay. Let's look around where I need to go. Because there's a couple of paths here, and I don't want to take the wrong one. I think I want to go that way, actually. So... Upsy-daisy. And around here. We got these wall piston things. Oops. Gotta time myself a little better here. Sit. Oh. I'm gonna try it like this. Oh. I think this will be a little bit faster and easier. Oh, dang it. Well, maybe I don't need that lower one. Yeah, I don't think I need the lower one at all. Okay. Oh, this isn't the star that I'm looking for. But I could grab that now if I wanted to. That's... Maybe this isn't the right path. Because I want to get to there. Maybe I shouldn't have done a second star. Okay, up here then. Just trying to think. Sorry for the lack of commentary. And get across. Carefully wait for the block to stop moving so that you have a shot. Alright. Just gotta be careful in this level and you are okay. Oh god. Well, when they're like that, that's not really that big of a deal. Okay. And one more root for good measure. Where is the Thwomp area? Is it... How much higher do I have to go? Yeah, this level is a lot larger than it initially seems, because it just keeps going up and keeps going up. That's the star that I'm looking for, okay. Get on this, then this, and there we go. Almost there. Can I reach that? Or do I have to, use the clock hand? Dang it! Oh, I shouldn't have picked the star. This is gonna make this part abnormally long, then. you can't grab on the edges of those triangles, so be careful of those. At least I don't think you can grab the edges of them. Wait a second, where's the hand? I thought it came through here, or maybe it's just not here yet. Oh, I gotta wait. Oh, it's that other star all over again. You see, the hand leads you over to that platform, of which you jump on top of Thwomp to get that star. Another star! At least I'm safe from the flame orb there. From this distance, so I can wait it out pretty comfortably. Just wait, don't get too close. Just be patient, PkGam. There we go. Well, at least you got the Benny Hill Yakety Sax music going on here in the background to have you... give you a good time along the way, I suppose. Wait, is this gonna go under the platform? Yeah, I think it's gonna go under, so it should probably go a little bit off like that. Yeah, that's safer. And double jump up to the star. There you go. Here we go. Woo! Yeah, that took a lot longer than I thought. So with that, I'm gonna end off the part here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next part.